topic that will continue, it is malabsorption syndrome. So what is this malabsorption syndrome? So malabsorption, it is a general term. Okay, malabsorption, it is usually a general term which is used to describe number of clinical conditions. Okay, it is used to describe number of clinical condition in which one nutrients are inadequately absorbed or it is not absorbed by the gastrointestinal tract. So that is malabsorption syndrome. So malabsorption, it is a general term which is used in number of clinical conditions in which one or more important nutrients, okay, one or more important nutrients, it is inadequately absorbed, okay, in which one or more important nutrients are inadequately absorbed by the GI tract with increased fecal content, okay, which increased fecal content of intestinal nutrients or bacterial degradation products. Okay, so that is usually what happens. Malabsorption, it is nothing but where it is a term, general term, which is used to describe many clinical condition in which one or more nutrients are not absorbed properly or inadequately absorbed by the GI tract with increased fecal matter. Okay, which increased fecal matter. So malabsorption syndrome occurs in those persons who are not able to absorb nutrients properly, vitamins and minerals properly from the food. So malabsorption syndrome occurs in those individuals who are not able to absorb vitamins, minerals, nutrients from the food. So malabsorption, it is a general term which is used to describe in many conditions that they are not able to absorb one or more important nutrients by the GI tract with increased fecal matter. So this syndrome, that is malabsorption syndrome, occurs in those individuals they are not able to absorb nutrients properly, vitamins and minerals they are not able to absorb properly. So that is usually about this malabsorption syndrome. So next is causes. So causes, it includes is that it might be due to infective agents. Okay, causes, it might be due to infective agents. Okay, there are many causes. So we'll see what are the causes. Like first is due to infective agents. Okay, due to infective agents like intestinal tuberculosis, HIV, parasitic infections. So that is usually what happens. So this might be due to infective agents like infective tuberculosis, HIV or parasitic infection. Next is due to structural defects. Okay, it can be caused due to structural defects such as inflammatory bowel disease. Okay, it can be due to structural defects such as inflammatory bowel disease, which might be including like Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis. Okay, Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis, so it is inflammatory bowel disease. Then diverticulitis, okay, in case if the person is suffering from diverticulitis or if there is irritable bowel syndrome, okay, if there is irritable bowel syndrome. So that is mainly due to structural defects such as inflammatory bowel disease, or it might be due to diverticulitis, or it might be due to irritable bowel syndrome. So next, it might be due to any mucosal abnormalities. Okay, it can be due to any mucosal abnormality like celiac disease, Crohn's disease, fructose malabsorption. Okay, so that is, it might be due to mucosal insufficiency, such as celiac disease, Crohn's disease, or fructose malabsorption. Then it might be due to digestive failure. Okay, it might be due to digestive failure in case of pancreatitis, carcinoma of pancreas, obstructive jaundice, bacterial overgrowth. Okay, it might be due to digestive failure that might be occurring in the pancreatitis, bacterial overgrowth, obstructive jaundice, or cancer of the carcinoma of the pancreas. And this can also occur, this malabsorption syndrome can also occur due to any other diseases that is affecting the GI tract. Okay, due to other diseases that is affecting the GI tract. It might be like hypothyroidism or hyperthyroidism. So it can be due to hypothyroidism or hyperthyroidism, or if the person is suffering from Addison's disease, okay, if the person is suffering from Addison's disease, or if the person is suffering from diabetes, or if the person is having mastocytosis. So that is, it can occur due to any other diseases that is affecting the GI tract, that is mainly hyperthyroidism, hypothyroidism, Addison's disease, or diabetes mellitus, or mastocytosis. Then it can be due to drug induced. Okay, the cause can be due to drug induced, such as usage of antacids or neomycin. Okay, usage of antacids or neomycin. So these are usually the causes of this malabsorption syndrome. So what is this malabsorption? It is a condition in which one or more nutrients, that is important nutrients, will not be absorbed by the GI tract, or with increased fecal matter. Okay, with increased fecal matter. And then this malabsorption syndrome occurs in those persons who are not able to absorb nutrients, vitamins and minerals from the food. So there are many causes. The causes might be due to infective agents such as tuberculosis, HIV or parasitic infection, and it can be due to mucosal diseases such as celiac disease, Crohn's disease and fructose intolerance. It might be due to structural defects such as inflammatory bowel disease, irritable bowel syndrome, or it might be due to diverticulitis. Then it might be due to diseases that is affecting the GI tract like hyperthyroidism, hypothyroidism, and then diabetes mellitus, mastocytosis, and it can be due to digestive failure in chronic pancreatitis, carcinoma of pancreas, or in case of bacterial overgrowth. Okay, in case of bacterial overgrowth, or it can be due to drug induced such as usage of antacids or neomycin. So next is clinical symptoms. So what are the symptoms that can be seen in case of this malabsorption syndrome is that the person with suffering from this malabsorption syndrome might develop constipation, diarrhea, foul smell, stool. Okay, the stools will be very bad smell. Okay, they'll be having very bad smell. Dry skin will be there, fatigue will be there, weakness, bloating, and also they'll be having mental difficulties such as confusion, depression. That is usually about this thing will be there. And then in females, they'll be having premenstrual syndrome. Okay, they'll be having premenstrual syndrome in the females. Muscle cramps will be there. Steatorrhea develops. So what is this steatorrhea? Steatorrhea, it is nothing but pale, bulky, fatty stools. Okay, it is nothing but pale, bulky, fatty stools. Then they'll be having failure to grow normally. Okay, they'll be having failure to grow normally. Unexplained weight loss will be there. Okay, unexplained weight loss will be there. Visual difficulties can be seen. Okay, visual difficulties can be seen as well as anemia. So these are usually the symptoms that is usually seen in case of this malabsorption syndrome. So that is constipation, frequent diarrhea will be there, foul smell, stools will be there, steatorrhea will be there, unexplained weight loss, anemia, and then they'll be having dry skin, fatigue, weakness. They'll be having like mental disturbances such as they'll not be able to concentrate properly. There'll be a depression, menstrual muscle cramps will be there, premenstrual syndrome will also be present. So that is usually the symptoms usually it includes is that constipation, diarrhea, foul smell, stools, fatigue, weakness, mental disabilities will be there like depression as well as failure to concentrate, bloating will be there, and they'll be having like anemia, they'll not be able to grow normally, unexplained weight loss will be there, muscle cramps will be there, as well as premenstrual syndrome will be present in the female. So these are the symptoms that is usually associated with malabsorption syndrome. So that is diagnostic evaluation. So what are the diagnostic will be? So there is no specific test that has been declared that the person is suffering from malabsorption syndrome. So other than that, so in order to confirm with diagnosis, they go with blood test. Like in the blood test, they'll go with routine blood test. Like for checking this anemic, or like HB level and all will be checked so that we know that the person is anemic or not. And then we go with low calcium and phosphate level will be there. Okay, low calcium and phosphate level will be there. Then we go with specific vitamins test. Okay, like vitamin D or macronutrients test will be done. So to know, like specific vitamin deficiency test will be done to know whether the vitamins are deficiency, because in malabsorption they will not be able to absorb vitamins. Okay, they will not be able to absorb vitamins. So therefore we have to check with whether vitamin deficiency is present or not. Then we go with lactose tolerance test. Okay, we go with lactose tolerance test. So first is blood test. So blood test we go with like routine test will be there to check anemia. Then we go with like checking vitamin deficiency is there or not. So that will be checking. Lactose tolerance test will be done. Then stool examination will be done. Like microscopic studies will be done. Okay, in this stool examination, microscopic studies will be done. Then we go with radiological examination. Okay, then we go with radiological examinations like barium studies, like barium X-ray will be done. So this barium studies will be the barium enema will be given. Barium studies like X-ray will be taken. Then we go with CT abdomen. Okay, CT abdomen is done in order to know any structural abnormalities is there. Then MRI, then magnetic resonance, cholangiopancreatography will be done. So I have told you that if there is any pancreatic disorders, then also this can occur. So therefore we go with magnetic resonance cholangiopancreatography will be done. So where we'll be checking about the pancreas. So this is the examination that is usually done in order to confirm malabsorption syndrome. Blood test, routine test is done. Then we go with vitamin deficiency test will be done. Then we go with lactose tolerance test will be done. Then stool examination, microscopic studies will be done. Then we go with other radiological tests such as barium enema, a CT scan of the abdomen. Then magnetic MRCP, that is magnetic resonance cholangiopancreatography will be done. So this is about this diagnostic test that is usually done. So then we go with management. So in case of this management, treatment depends upon the cause as well as the symptoms that is usually present. So main aim is to reduce the symptoms. Okay, main aim is to reduce the symptoms so that they'll be able to absorb nutrients properly. So therefore, first thing is that we have to replace nutrients. Okay, as nutrients is not absorbed properly, so we have to replace nutrients as well as fluid and electrolyte. This is very necessary. So that is to be done. Then in severe cases, we have to admit the, like we have to hospitalize the patient, and this nutrients, fluid and electrolytes should be replaced. Parenteral administration should be done. Then antibiotics can be given in order to reduce the bacterial overgrowth. So that is metronidazole, it is usually given. Okay, metronidazole is usually given. So antibiotics should be given. Then we go with dietary modifications. Okay, we have to go with dietary modifications. Okay, so whichever the diet that has been, that has to be taken, so that has to be taken. That is, eat diet which is having high in carbohydrates, low in fat. Okay, so eat diet which is having high in carbohydrates and low in fat. Then include diet like rice should be cooked properly, use brown rice. Okay, rice should be cooked properly, use brown rice. Oatmeal can be taken, millets can be taken, vegetables should be steamed and eaten. Okay, so vegetables should be steamed and eaten. So that is usually, and also you can use aloe vera and peppermint. Okay, also you can use aloe vera and peppermint so that it can aid in digestion. Okay, aloe vera and peppermint can be used so that it aids in digestion. So consume fresh papaya. We ask them to consume fresh papaya and pineapple regularly. So in case of this malabsorption syndrome, so management that is usually depends upon the three causes as well as the symptoms. So it is mainly done here. The aim is to reduce the symptoms so that the nutrients are absorbed properly. So in order to correct this nutrition deficiency, we have to go with parenteral administration of the nutrients and fluids and electrolytes. Then we can go with giving antibiotics to reduce the bacterial infection, like metronidazole, which is also given. Then we have to maintain this healthy eating habits, like carbohydrates should be taken, low fat should be taken, papaya and pineapple should be regularly taken. And then in order to aid for a good aid in digestion, we can use this aloe vera and peppermint can be used. Then oatmeal can be added. So these are usually the dietary changes that we have to do in order to go with reduce this malabsorption syndrome. So that is usually about this malabsorption syndrome. So malabsorption syndrome is nothing but where the person will not be able to absorb nutrients, vitamins and minerals from the food.